by the head coach of the USF Dons, Todd Golden, alongside with us. And, you know, Coach, a good bounce back game for your guys. You played, here we were sitting here 24 hours ago wrapping up a ball game, and we do it again tonight, but your guys showed a lot of energy, especially at the start of half number two.
Yeah, no question. It was honestly, like we talked about before the game, I thought we played well last night.
Oh, yeah.
We didn't make shots. And, again, you look tonight, I thought we executed similarly defensively. We did a great job, especially in the second half, you know, locking them down. And really the difference in the game is instead of going, you know, 8 for 28 from 3, which I think we were last night, we go 12 for 29. That's the separator. That's who we are. And when we shoot the ball like that, we're tough to beat.
You know, Jordan Rutino, you know, he struggled with shooting here these last couple of nights, Todd. It was nice to see him hit a couple in the late going. But a lot of people forget that he always guards the best offensive player on the other team. He drew Bradley here tonight, draped all over him a lot in the first half. And Bradley had 9 points at one point in the first half. And he played the last 30 minutes scoring 2 points, an all-around good defensive effort on him, not just from Rutino, but also from Minlin.
Yeah, no doubt. And Jordan's, you know, he's a winner, man. And, you know, a lot of casual basketball fans don't understand how difficult it is to defend the toughest perimeter player on the other team every night. And Jordan's the guy that gets that assignment. He's nails. He's trustworthy out there. We know that he's never going to lose his guy. And, you know, for him to punch those two threes out in the second half, I'm sure, obviously it felt great for us. I'm sure it felt great for him as well, kind of breaking the seal. And, you know, three-point shooters that, you know, sometimes they run hot, they run cold. And Jordan's a kid that we'll always rely upon to play a lot in his senior year. He's earned it. He's done a great job, and I'm proud of him.
Solid effort for your big in the inside. Jimbo Law finishes with 20 points on 7 of 10 shooting, made 6 for 7 at the free throw line. You know, he was battling against a youngster, a 7-foot freshman, but Jimbo really went at it inside. They were putting a couple different guys on him, Kelly and Tiemann, yep. and Jimbo just kept going at it inside.
Yeah, and what Jimbo's really – where he's really grown is he's done a phenomenal job managing the double team. You know, these teams, everybody we faced to this point in the season at some point in the game has run a double team at him, and they're running it from the baseline, they're running it from the nail. And he's, you know, after that first, you know, couple possessions where he was a little out of sorts, you know, he did a phenomenal job handling it the rest of the night. It either led for points for him or kick out threes for our other guys. And Jimbo's another guy, four-year player, been in our program for a long time, has gotten incrementally better every year. And for him to go 20-8 against Cal on the backside of a back-to-back, I mean, it's just incredible, man. And it's why this team has a chance to do something special.
You guys showed a lot of the 1-3-1 after the start of the second half. What led to that decision? Obviously, it really worked for you. It kind of threw Cal out of its rhythm.
Yeah, we have it in our back pocket. And, you know, we try to pride ourselves on to be a man-to-man team. But, you know, we just thought with them playing point guards that weren't exactly perimeter scoring threats, that it would kind of bottle them up and make them stagnant. We haven't played it a lot lately, and we thought this was a game that we could show it a little bit. And it was just, you know, Coach Njai, who I rely upon for a lot of my defensive stuff this year, you know, him and I were talking at halftime. We thought that this would be a great opportunity to do it in the second half to try to catch him off guard. And sure enough, it really worked, and it really slowed them down. Also, what you also don't realize is when we get misses out of that zone, we run. We can run out of that, get some transition, and we got some of that in the second half.
You now have 9 days between ball games, and obviously it's, you know, final exams. They are student athletes,
yep.
But there's that balance of you still want to get them on the practice floor and keep them fresh for your next ball game at Fullerton. So what will it be like over the next nine days or so?
We'll definitely give them some time here. You know, the next couple of days will be off and fully focused on their studies and making sure that they do a good job finishing the semester. It's a very important part of our program. Our guys are really prideful in terms of doing well in the classroom. So we'll let them, you know, get centered on that, make sure that they're organized and ready to attack those. And really, we'll get a lot of skill work in. You know, we got to kind of rejuvenate a little bit. We're a little banged up with Tavi being out. We need to make sure after this back-to-back that we kind of refresh and get ready. So we'll have a couple hard practices, but really we'll focus on some skill and make sure that we're sharp when we get down to Fullerton.
All right, Coach, appreciate the post-game visit. Enjoy the next 9 days, and we'll – We'll see you down the road when the Dons head to Southern California.
I can promise you that I will enjoy it a lot more after tonight's win.
There you go.
Enjoy. Thanks, Pat.
All right.